We know from the clinical trials that adjuvant chemotherapy given is usually 4 cycles of cisplatin-based treatment, so about 3 months of therapy, helps improve survival on the order of 5 to 10%. And those were in multiple trials that included patients of various ages. In a couple of them, the investigators have looked back at the subsets of patients who were older. And in the JBR10 in particular, which was a Canadian study looking at cisplatin vinorelbine, and also looking at the LACE meta-analysis, which included that and 4 other large trials, they both showed that in the elderly population defined as over 65 in the LACE meta-analysis, that those patients were not able to tolerate the chemotherapy quite as well, but seemed to have a survival benefit nonetheless. But I always use caution. I think we need to be very aware of the toxicities of the chemotherapy. We know from patients with metastatic disease that well-selected elderly patients do just as well as younger patients. However, that's looking at 65 or 70 as the cut point. When we get into the octogenarians, there are very few patients in their 80s who are fit for chemo. However, we do know that for those who are fit, giving combination chemotherapy can be done. We know that from the recently published French trial that patients receiving doublet chemotherapy who were elderly did better than patients receiving single drugs as far as overall survival. There is, of course, that additional toxicity. We need to be cautious in who we select. But there are fit patients in their 80s who we should be treating the same as other patients with adjuvant chemotherapy. It's just about the selection.